Hello everyone, this is going to be part two of my Civilization 5 playthrough, in which in part one I rolled the Koreans on a Pangea map, and it actually turned out to be a pretty good roll. I got a huge area with no competition lined up in it, and that's a pretty unusual roll. I think it's the first time it's ever happened for me. I also got a pretty good starting lie for my capital city, and as a result of the map roll, I was able to clear something like a dozen ancient ruins. I got first religion, first pantheon obviously, and I'm well on my way to accumulating faith for my second great prophet. And that will potentially allow me to enhance my religion. Now, because I managed to get first religion and first pantheon, I suspect the Celts are not in the game, because if they get a forest start, they'll have their first pantheon in 20 or 30 turns, whereas anybody else actually has to find some way to acquire faith. So the fact that I got first pantheon pretty much confirms that the Celts are not in the game. Anyway, on with the game. When I left things, I was heading off to take care of this barbarian camp. And I was starting on the road to getting optics. Now I just need to get things rolling here. So, I'm going to take out this encampment here. Now, while I'm doing that, I'm going to mention that I have the music turned off here, partly because I find it annoying after a while, and partly because there's a really good chance I'd get a copyright strike if I kept that music in the background. So I've turned it off. All I've got is some potential ambience and that sort of thing. But I find it's probably safer for this sort of thing to do the playthroughs and so on, simply to have no music going in the background. It also means that it doesn't obscure what I'm saying if it happens to be too loud or something like that. Of course, there's still a chance that I'll get a strike based on the fact that, you know, it's the game assets are showing. Now, okay, interesting here. I've got a promotion. Okay, here's that one promotion I was talking about before where you heal every turn even if you do something. But I'm going to take Barrage 3 for the promotion here. And it looks like somebody has finally selected a Pantheon. That means that there's a really good chance that somebody's going to enhance or found a religion or enhance it. No, found it before I get to enhance mine. Anyway, I'll keep on going here. Okay, so I'll clear that camp, and that makes me friends with Sophia. Let's see. Okay, so there's a barbarian boat which I can put paid to if it sticks around. Now, I'm not seeing any other barbarian encampments on the map, but that doesn't mean they aren't there. Fog of war and all, so I'm going to have to, you know, patrol some and see if there are any. Okay. going to look around my capital more than anywhere else because I want to make sure that I don't get barbarians proliferating here. Oh, policy. This is nice. Okay, so what options have I got here? I can raise for my Reformation belief. Or I can... this one is nice looking. This gets me a worker. I'm going to go for that one because I really need the worker and it saves me buying it. And that happens to be exactly a good spot here. 16 turns if I make a farm there. So I'm going to farm my wheat. Then I'm going to improve the elephant ivory here because I'm going to need the happiness from the luxury resources. Now, by improving my wheat here, I'm going to unstagnate soil, and that will help some. Okay, I can take a whack at this, galley. I see I'm not seeing any barbarian encampments near my capital, which is good. Okay. Next time I manage to take a whack at that galley, it'll be done, I think. Yeah, the barbarians aren't very smart with where they move their units around. No, I can't see that. Okay. So they'll go back and forth, into and out of range of a city instead of elsewhere, and they won't attack the city, which makes it easy to deal with them, but it makes you wonder what they're up to. Okay. Oh, somebody else founded a pantheon. So that means a whole bunch of people have probably just made it to pottery. Right. Oh, I found some barbarians. This is good. I really want to get this up to 1160 so I can buy a settler. Now, an interesting fact about the game is it's a 32-bit program, which means that even though I have a 64-bit system, it has some limitations on available resources. That means that a lot of things tend to be slower than they would need to be because it has to evacuate information from memory just to keep things within the resources available to it. Now, the 32-bit binary makes it more portable than anything else, but a 64-bit binary would actually make the game run faster, especially with a huge map, because there'd be a lot more memory available to keep track of things. That's not so big of an issue this early on in the game, but as it gets later, it'll be much more obvious why that's a potential problem. As you see the map paint itself and that sort of thing. Okay, good. Now, if I put a mine here, I increase production by one. But I'm going to go over here and improve the ivory. Okay, and the camp, it'll add one gold. And that'll be beneficial because I'm down to breaking even here. And it will also connect ivory, which will give me four happiness, and that will be extremely useful. So I'm just wandering around here looking for barbarians. Okay, so I really am going to need to start working on my military. That's what this pointiest sticks is all about. Now, I'm about middle of the road here, but if you notice, the next one up is quite a lot higher. And this is accounted for just by my archer. Oh, I found some barbarians. This is good. Oh, that's sailing. Okay. Optics, that allows embarkation. Okay. Now, will that brute attack? No. Okay, that's good. Because I really need to take that archer out. Kind of wonder why he hasn't been attacking me with that archer. Because I could certainly be seen. Maybe the barbarian archers have a limited range, but no, they attack from two away before. This guy will move into the camp. There we go. Oh, there's the pyramids. Now, what can I build over here? That mausoleum of Halicarnassus could be useful, but instead I'm going to actually build a warrior. And I can go in here and put this back on the default focus. which will let the city grow faster. Okay, so I want to improve the iron, and I want to improve the horses. Mine. Okay, and you can see here it was only 13 turns to make a mine. That's one of the effects of the pyramid, and that's what makes it worth building it. Your workers work quite a lot faster, and it's definitely worth doing it, plus the two extra workers, which are nice. That means I haven't had to train a worker at all, which is quite helpful for getting things rolling here. Okay. There we go. That's that camp dealt with. So I'll wander around some more looking for barbarians. There's another brute. I think there's probably another camp around here somewhere. Oh, I got attacked. Which is fine. My guy defended, and that's good. You may note that the, this could be fun. I'm going to fortify him. Okay, so I've got my, camp there. I'll improve the, truffles as well. The luxury resources are worth having, for the happiness, among other things. Okay, I've got a promotion here. Now, I could take the heal instantly here, but I think I'll go with the march promotion over the double thing. Well, no. I'll go for the two attacks, and I should be able to knock that guy down so he's not going to attack. The march promotion would be nice, but I think the double attack is better. Basically, how that double attack works is attacking consumes a movement point, and then you can move or attack after you attack. And it's really quite useful. It makes for a much more powerful unit, especially combined with the healing, the march one. Okay, so that's done. Now, I'm going to have to let that one recover. Okay, so a few turns. Temple of Artemis, somebody built that, which is fine. I never really go for the Temple of Artemis. It's not really so useful. It's not a bad one to get, for sure, but not getting it isn't the end of the world. Okay, as things go along here, it's going to take longer for the other players, city-states, barbarians, etc., to process. So it'll be longer between ending the turn and the next one starting. Okay, good. That's the iron. Where, I might as well, since I don't have anything better to do, build some farms here. And I'll go ahead and improve the truffles over here for when I do meet somebody. Okay, so I've got my warrior. Now, what to build here? I think I need to build a settler. Okay, this guy's ready to wander around some more, and I'll improve my truffles there. Somebody else made a pantheon. Okay, food from camps. That would have been a good choice, actually, food from camps, but I hadn't. Actually been paying enough attention, but again, elsewhere I've got wheat all over, so I don't know that it was a bad choice. Okay. Ooh, that could be exciting. Okay, so that's that. And I guess I need a camp there. Yeah, I would have been better if I'd chosen the food from camps, because you got a camp, a camp, a camp, and a camp. Still, what's done is done. So, and no use whining about it. I'll work away at this barbarian here. As you can see, that multiple attacks thing makes a huge difference. And I think this is probably why the cap is there on barbarian experience. So you can't go out and get a bunch of units with the double attack capability and then use that to go and blitz your neighbors. Oh, there we go. We got a hand axe spawned there. Now the hand axe is a ranged unit. If I backed off one, it wouldn't be able to attack me, but I should take him out long before I run out of hit points there, so it should be okay to leave it there. Plus, I still need to be able to see this guy to attack him. Now, it can be quite fun if you're playing the Germans. You can actually, you have a chance of having the barbarian unit join you if you when you defeat it. So you can actually be wandering around with hand axes and brutes, which is kind of amusing. Now they do upgrade to normal units, so it's not that big of a loss to or it's not a problem to have it. I'm gonna let that guy heal. Now I'm losing money now for some reason. What's my cost? Three from building maintenance. Okay. So what happens if you go negative and you've got no gold in the bank is the deficit is made up from your science gain there. So you really want to avoid having a substantial deficit. Running a deficit gold-wise can severely cripple your science production. And you definitely don't want to do that during the early game, although that tends to be when it happens. This guy's healed, so I'm wandering around more looking for barbarians. I'm pretty much out of things for the settlers to do now until I build a city. So I'm gonna just park that guy. Now you might be wondering why I'm chopping down the forest and building a farm. Well, my play style, I'm actually going to aim for large cities because that allows generating great people and so on much more easily. And it gives you larger science and so on because that's all based on population from the science buildings. So it's definitely worth going for larger settlements over lots of them, although lots of them does work as well. But as you can see from hovering here, every city increases the cost of a technology by 2%, and there is an increase in costs for social policies as well. So you want to avoid that as much as you can, at least in the early game, unless you are aiming for a pure cultural victory, in which case lots of cities really does help because it allows you to have a massive culture build that will guard you against your opponents being able to become influential against you. Okay, so that's pretty much it for here. So until the city borders expand, so I'll have to leave that alone. I'm going to get my settler right away here, so that'll be good. Arch. Yeah, that's the one I want. Okay. Now, what am I building here? A granary would be a good idea. City will grow faster. It's suggesting I build a city here. Or way over here. Okay, that's on... Well, that has a luxury resource. Here I have stone. I'd be competing with Sophia for land, but it's within two of a mountain. Yeah, I think that's a good option. Where's my, I should follow with my with a warrior. I don't want the settler taken by barbarians. That's the warrior, right? It should take the same path as the settler, so that should move them together. Okay, there's optics. Okay, so now I just need to bring this guy into my territory. And, okay, yeah, so Temple of Artemis would have been engineering points and faster growth. Okay, I'm going to go for writing. Now, as you'll see down here, I move in there, and there's the embarkation promotion. So now I can send my guy over here. And then I can actually start exploring. And you can see these two are in fact moving together. See, and this is why I sent the warrior along. Oh, I'm up to 600 faith here. I'm not going to buy anything because I really need that great profit. But I'll go after this camp here. Um, I am, of course, still hoping that I get to enhance before somebody else founds a religion. That would be really nice, because then I'll get my mosques that I want. I'll be able to clear this next turn, and I'll be able to build my city over here next turn. Now, you might think I'd be better off to build, say, over here or over here, but being beside the river is actually better. It makes attacking across the river harder. Even though I'm competing harder with Sophia for land, but I'll have these tiles here, and Sophia is not going to expand over the mountains particularly quickly. I wouldn't think it's probably going to be expanding over here. Anyway, and it's the archer that is waiting for me to do something. There we go. Cleared the camp. And that's a warrior there. I'm just going to. Okay, so this would be okay, but it's all water, right? And here I get the benefit of the copper and the mountains nearby. So I'll build my city there. Okay, and I will build, first off, a shrine. Even though the shrine will finish not too long before the great prophet eligibility arrives. Okay, I'm just gonna duck across there. Okay, great lighthouse is worth building, so I'm going to do that. Okay, so now I'm well on my way to exploring there. I've got this settler here doing nothing, so I can send it over here to start improving things there. And that settler's done with everything it can do over there, so I'll send it over here. What to do over here? Well, okay, now I can start wandering around here and meeting places and barbarians and so on. And speaking of barbarians, ooh. I want to go after the spearman here first. Oh, somebody else is attacking too. Okay. Okay, let's clear the camp. And here I meet somebody, Assyria. So that's who was attacking the spearman. Okay, so that's a hill. But I can make a mine or a farm. A mine. Because it's much easier to generate food from ocean tiles than it is to generate production. Okay, this is interesting. He's offering horses and 1 gold for truffles. Sure. It'll make them happier over time, and it clears my deficit largely. Okay, so I'll build a mine on my copper. And keep exploring over here. Okay, fine. I don't really care if he knows where my capital is. They're gonna. Oh, a religion was founded. Okay. Let's see what they picked. Religion overview. Beliefs. Eastern Orthodox monasteries. Okay, it's monasteries. That's okay. And I'm 200 faith off of my next great profit. Okay, I can't build a great library anymore. And attack the barbarian, of course. The great library gives you a free technology. I got several of those from ancient ruins, so I'm not really hurting as a result of that. There we go, that's the barbarian killed there. I'm going to go around killing barbarians. I might want to open honor so I get culture for doing it. Oh, there's the camp. I knew there had to be one nearby. Okay. After I clear this one, I think I'll buy a settler, build another city. Okay, well, I'm apparently the richest of everybody. Now, what do I want to go for? I'm going to go for philosophy. The Oracle gives me a free social policy. That's, a risk, because it's a long research road on that, but I think it's worth taking the gamble on that. And I was, oh, right, I'm gonna have to move this the worker out of there, and I can buy a settler. Okay. Right, okay. Now, where am I going to put my city? not sure I want to crowd my capital city, but what's up here? I've got a luxury resource. Actually, I think I want to go down here. I've got iron over here. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that'd be reasonable. Okay. Yeah, I figure it'd be worth picking on those guys for a bit, for the experience. Especially since they can't attack back. Okay. I'm going to come up on a golden age pretty soon here. That'll be good. Okay, that's that done. Okay. Okay, now the perfect spacing here would be to have 6 tiles in between, because cities can work up to 3. But I don't want to settle on the wheat, because then I don't get the benefits of it. So the benefits of improving it. Now if I build my city here also, this becomes less of a worry. So I'll put up my city, and now of course I can start picking that off. And I'll build a shrine. Now, this would be a good city for the Petra because of the desert tiles. That's desert wheat, but plains wheat would be better. But with all of the desert tiles, Petra would be a good wonder here. I can't remember what you need for Petra. Obviously, I don't have it yet. Okay. One of the problems with desert is it doesn't produce much. So I'm not getting much production out of that city, but it'll be a good city later. And that's a hill. So I'm going to lose food if I mine it, but I'm going to. This city's going to have good production. And once I have a lighthouse and so on in here, these coastal tiles will be actually quite good. There's a lot of barbarian ships floating around here. That must be a little island there. Okay, so I'll keep on fiddling around here. What have we got over here? This could be risky with the ships floating around. Anyway. Okay, so that camp shouldn't be an issue for a while. Ooh, a ruin. What? Right. I need to build something here. A monument. So I got about 10 turns or so before I get a profit. Oh, barbarians, that's going to be fun. Okay, promotion. Cover or range? Range. That extra range will be good when I end up upgrading it to a Gatling gun where you actually lose range. The early archery units kind of get nerfed in the later game because you actually lose range. Oh, this is going to be a risk. Okay. Ooh, a golden age. That's cool. And I got away with that. Okay, what have I got here? I get increased population. You know what? I'm gonna go for culture. Now, that also means I have enough culture for a policy. So, well, that's interesting. I've got a golden age already. This, I think, is going to be better. Right, okay. And then the next one can be this one where I get a settler. But this plus one production in every city should be should help, say, over here. And I need to start building some military here. Anyway. So I'll take apart this encampment and take that ship out. Ooh, I got a great general, I think it is. Yeah, great general. So I'll let him hang out in Seoul. Okay. Great generals are nice because you can use them to expand your territory. By making citadels, or you can use them to improve your combat strength during military operations. Okay, now I want to get back on the mainland. But I really need to take these guys out first. So I don't want to get attacked while I'm embarked. Now I don't have the wheel yet, so I can't build the roads to link everything. but I do want to get over here. let's see. I've got a tile there I can improve in the city range now. Looks like the Great Lighthouse is just about done. Maybe I'll actually get it. Okay. So that's going to be a farm. Got a hand axe there now. What have I got here? Okay. Well, I think a workboat would be a good choice here. For this. Okay. Once this is done, I need to build some units here, defensive at least. Okay, that's the Great Lighthouse. Now, what I need to build here. Spearmen aren't really a great investment for the future. They upgrade to pikemen, which then upgrade to lancers. Lancers aren't so helpful, really. And then that's an anti-tank gun, and then a helicopter gunship. But I find that they're not hugely useful once you get out of the horse era. So I don't tend to build spearmen. I will build archers because they ultimately upgrade to modern armors. And warriors ultimately upgrade to mech infantry. So that makes them both good long-term investments. So I'm going to build some warriors here. Ooh, there's my profit. That's really good. So I'll enhance my religion. But I will deal with this other stuff here first. Okay. Second follower belief. I get mosques. I like mosques because you get happiness and faith. You get more faith than you do with cathedrals, and you get more culture. I'm going to go, and it doesn't have any resource dependencies. So, mosques. And then I will, over time, build pagodas and mosques in all my cities, which helps both my culture and my faith and the happiness. As if I build both, I get +3 happiness, +4 faith, and +4 culture. And the enhancer belief. Let's see. Do I want faster spreading or further away? Given where I'm located, I think further away. Okay, enhance religion. Now, this was a particularly lucky game for the religion because it got me to where I actually wanted to go for my gameplay style. Now, I don't play a conquer the world type game style, so it actually benefits me greatly to get the pagodas and mosques. Anyway, I'll keep on. The The archer beat the galley at sea. Okay, now I'm back on the mainland. Okay, so I'll kill the archer here, and I'll kill that off. Until I have a unit that can wander around and clear this, it'll keep generating units. But if I keep the unit in the camp destroyed, I won't get them marauding around. Now, I think I'm coming up on an hour on this part, if I haven't made an hour. So I'll do a couple more turns here, and then I'll call it a part, I think. I'm just looking around at stuff here. Yeah, I think that's what I'll do anyway. This here would be a prime spot for a pontoon bridge, for shortening the distance there. Okay. Ah, I had an expansion there. Okay, so I'll go one more turn. I'll set that worker working. This will be a pasture. And then from there, let's see. Where is this guy going? I'll send him over this way. And a pasture. Okay, so. Okay, that one's growing. That's good. Where does... Okay, it's going to go for the plains wheat first on expansion. That's good. That tile will actually be better than this one, which it's currently working. So this would be a good one as well, but that comes with production. Right, okay. And I need my pantheon here, or my religion here, to expand here so I get the pantheon belief, which increases the food from those. Okay. So I'm going to save the game here. That's turn 253. So save the game. So I'm going to call it a part here. So I've got two more cities out, and I've got my religion enhanced. Over the next bit, I'm going to fill out Liberty, probably work on filling out, or at least. Getting to the Reformation belief for my religion, and then the religion will be completely set. Anyway, that's all for this time. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.